Hello students, with this session we will start our discussion with electrical maintenance 1 practicals, experiment number 1. The aim of a practical is to connect one lamp, one switch and fuse in a circuit that we have to prepare with PVC casing and capping. So, this is a wiring practical, and for this practical, we will require the following list of tools. First, we will require screwdriver, which will be of a flat blade type, quantity 1. So, this is a screwdriver that we will be using for our experiment. Next, we will use combination plier of 15 cm in quantity 1. So this is a combination plier that we will be using for our practical. Next is a hammer for fixing the screws on wooden board of about 500 grams. So this is a hammer that we will need. Next is a poker for creating the holes for screws of about 10 cm, quantity 1. So this is a poker with a wooden base, we can see, which is used for our wiring practical. Next is a hacksaw, adjustable frame type. So we can also use a smaller size of a hacksaw for our practical, for cutting the PVC casing capping to the desired length. This hacksaw will contain an hacksaw blade, and here we can see it is a smaller size blade, but for practicals we can also use a larger size of a blades, which are available in around 20 cm long length. Next is electrician's knife, that is around 5 cm in length. So this is an electrician knife which is used for removing the insulation of a wire or a cable which are having a higher thickness. Next is a wire stripper. So this is a wire stripper that we will use for removing the insulation of a wire that we will be using for the wiring practicals. So for this practical of wiring, we will require following list of materials. As we have to do the wiring in casing and capping, we will use casing capping of specification 3x4 inches or 20 mm of around 2 feet long. So we will use such kind of casing capping for making the layout of our wiring. We will use a batten holder or a lamp holder of such type to fix the lamp, so of the rating 5 ampere to 40 volt for a single phase supply. We will use single pole single throw switch, that will be a one way switch that will be requiring for our practical. So this is a one way switch, such kind of a switch fixed on the gang box, we will require one. We will require fuse that we have to use in circuit at the time of starting for protection purpose. So fuse is also fixed on the gang box. Next we will require PVC wire. So we will use such red insulated wire and black color insulated wire for phase and neutral connection of 1 square mm copper wire of around length 6 feet. We will use a PVC square box for fixing the lamp holder in our layout. We will use gang box, which is used for fixing the fuse as well as the switches on it. We will use different size of screws for fixing the layout on the wooden block. So here the size of screws has been mentioned in the different quantities required for our experiment. So with these materials required, let us first of all understand the layout of our practical. So students, let us go through the layout diagram for this experiment. So in all total we have to draw 3 diagrams for wiring practicals. So first one, here I am showing layout diagram. It is the layout that we have to actually prepare on the wooden board. This layout we have to prepare with the help of casing and capping. So this layout will look like as the diagram that I have shown on the whiteboard. We will be fixing casing and capping over the wooden block. We will be fixing one-way switch and the fuse at the bottom of the casing capping that are fixed on the gang box. On the top of casing capping, we will fix a square box, and over the square box we will fix a lamp holder to fix the lamp for the experiment. And from this side of a casing capping, okay, we will be inserting two wires. One will be phase that I have indicated by red, and one will be neutral wire, and we will do the wiring connection inside the casing and capping. So here a T type of connection is forming between casing and capping, so we indicate it as a three-way T. So with this layout diagram, let us first understand the circuit diagram of the practical. So students, let us go through circuit diagram and the connections that we have to make for this experiment. Firstly, we will require phase and neutral, that is single phase 230 volt 50 hertz AC supply, to be taken from the switchboard with the help of a switch. Then the phase wire, first of all we will make the connection to the fuse, as we have to bring the fuse in series connection. The output from the fuse we have to connect to the bottom terminal of the one-way switch. In one-way switch there will be two terminals, one will be a top and one will be a bottom terminal. So we will connect the output of the fuse to the bottom terminal of the switch. So here symbol of switch is indicating that the switch is open. From the top connection, top terminal of switch, we will take the connection of phase wire directly towards the lamp holder, wherein we will connect the phase wire at one of the terminal of lamp holder, over which we will fix a lamp. So across one terminal we will bring the connection of phase wire, and from the next terminal of the lamp holder we will take out a neutral wire, and that we will directly connect across the main neutral of the supply. So this completes our circuit for controlling one lamp with the help of a one-way switch. So let us move on to the wooden board and understand how to make the layout of this experiment and wiring diagram according to the circuit diagram. So students, we will understand how to prepare the layout of the wiring diagram or a wiring practical. So firstly, we will take a piece of a casing and we will fix it on the wooden board, and we will use a poker to make a hole through the PVC capping. Then we will fix a screw. We will hammer it a bit. And finally we will fix it with the screwdriver. So this is the fixing of a casing that we have fixed here. Same way we have to take another casing. We have to create the holes with the help of a poker, and we have to place it over the wooden block. So we have to fix the casing in such a way that it looks like our layout that we have gone through. We will take screws, we'll hammer it a bit, and with the help of screwdriver we have to fix it. Same way, we will fix one more screw. So this way, this is forming our layout. So according to the diagram of our practical layout diagram, this is the layout which we will be forming. Now through this layout we will be passing on our phase and neutral wire. So similarly we will be fixing first of all a fuse here after making the connection. Sideway of the fuse, we will be fixing a one-way switch in this way with the help of screws here, and we will be fixing a square box on the top, and over the square box we will fix a lamp holder. So let us go through the wiring. So students, now let us go through the wiring. So first of all, as we know that according to the layout, we have to take a phase wire here and we have to pass it on towards the fuse. So the phase wire first will be getting connected to the fuse. So we will use a stripper for proper removal of insulation. So this way we have to remove the insulation. And we have to twist the conductor for ease of making connection. Same way we have to do it for the next end. We have to twist this conductor. So this is just for the ease of making connections. So according to the layout, we will use this red wire as the phase wire that we have to put it from here, and we have to keep its connection open for making the connection of phase and neutral from supply, and one end from the other side end we have to connect it to the bottom terminal of the fuse. So we will take a fuse. So this is a fuse which is having two terminals, bottom and top. So we have to connect this wire at the bottom terminal of the fuse. We have to ensure the tightness of the connection. So this will be the phase wire which is coming towards the fuse that we have to fix it here at the bottom of the casing capping. Now from the top terminal of the fuse, according to circuit diagram, we have to take the wire to one-way switch. So this is a one-way switch which is having two terminals, top and bottom. So we have to remove these screws first. We have to make them loose for opening the terminal for connection. We will take a short length of a wire. Twist the strands. We will first of all make the connection towards the top terminal of the fuse. So to make it easy, we will bend it. We will place it in the terminal and we will fix the screw. So from here we will take the wire and we have to take it from the side towards the bottom terminal of the switch. So we'll take a small length of that. We have to make sure that while making the wiring, whatever extra length of wire is there, it should not be visible outside the layout. So we will twist it and we will bend it little bit and we will make the connection towards the bottom terminal of the switch here. We will fix the screw with the help of tester. So this is now fixed. So now from the top terminal of the switch, we have to take a phase wire upward and we will be taking this phase wire out from this square box, from these two ends or from these two openings we can see in the square box. So this fixing will look like this. This will be the position of this fuse, right? We will be fixing it here in this way, and in the side wire of the fuse we will be fixing one way switch like this, okay? And we will take out the phase wire connection from this end. So this will be the fixing of these two switches. So let us now take the connection from the top terminal of the switch. So we will take a long length of a wire because according to the length of our casing capping, we require a long length of wire. So we have to use the wire from the bundle of wire. So we will make a cut little bit for removing the insulation. We will twist the conductors. We will bend it little bit for ease of joining to the terminal. So now we will pass it on into the terminal in this way. So it is, you can see, because of bending the wire, it is very much easy to connect it, put it in the terminal. We will fit the screw. So from the top terminal of the switch, we have to take this wire towards the lamp holder. So this phase wire must come out from these openings provided on this square box, and we have to fix it in such a way that these wires should not be visible from any other end. So across this terminal we will be fixing a lamp holder, and one more wire that we have to use, we have to insert a neutral wire here, and we have to take it out from this opening for connection to the lamp holder. So for neutral wire we will take a wire with black color of insulation according to the length of our layout. So we have to, as we have seen in the layout, that we have to insert the black color neutral wire here, and we have to take it in the upward direction through the layout, and we have to bring this wire out of the square box. So firstly we will remove some part of our insulation. From both the ends, so now we have to use this neutral wire from this end, and we have to bring this out the terminal from the square box. So this will be the neutral wire which will be coming in the layout, and one phase wire will be running from the switch which will be coming out from this terminal of the square box. So this phase and neutral wire, we have to fix it to the lamp holder. We will fixing the switch here and a fuse here. So we will make the connection of this phase and neutral wire to holder. So we will see how to fix it and how the layout will look out after the fixing of that. So this is the wiring diagram that we have to remember how to move it inside the casing capping. So students, we can see after fixing fuse and one way switch and square box, now we need to connect a lamp holder. So there are two terminals in the lamp holder. Across one terminal we have to connect phase wire that is red in color, and across second terminal we have to connect neutral wire that is black in color. So we'll make this connection. We have to make sure while making the connections that not a single strand of phase and neutral gets touched to each other, and we have to ensure the tightness of the connection as well. Now we need to fix this lamp holder with the help of screws on this square box. So we will match the holes and we will fix it. So we fix the lamp holder. Now we can see the complete wiring within our layout. Now students, at this point let me tell you, one more diagram is there in this experiment that we need to go through, that is wiring diagram. So I will be drawing your wiring diagram that will make you understand. So in wiring diagram, our intention will be to show the path of a phase wire and neutral wire within the layout. For that indication, we use such kind of a slanting line of some bigger length. I am here indicating it by the red color to make you understand that the bigger line will indicate the path of a phase wire, and one smaller slanting line I am purposely using your black color, that will indicate the path of the neutral wire. So to draw this wiring diagram, firstly we have to draw single line same way as the layout. Here we will show one gang box having a switch in there. Here we will show a circle indicating holder and a lamp. So this is a single line which is representing the layout. As the layout is visible to us, we can see here it is in the form of a T shape. So firstly, as we can see in the layout, see the phase wire is passing through this horizontal casing once. So we will draw here one bigger line indicated by red, that will be the flow of phase wire here, and after that phase wire is going to the fuse and bottom terminal of a switch. So phase wire is going in this direction, so it is passing it here one. So we will indicate here one red line or long line indicating the phase wire flow. Now again from the switch, from the top terminal of switch, the phase wire is going to the in the upward direction towards the lamp holder. So from the switch here, the phase wire is going upward again. First it is coming downward, then it is again going upward. So two times here phase wire is going. As we can see, there are two red wires in the layout. So we will mark here another phase wire line of a bigger length and one line here, because here one phase wire is going in the top direction. Now from the lamp holder we are getting a black color neutral wire as the output in this portion. So we will represent this neutral line by a small slanting line, as I am indicating it here by a black color. So you can see that a neutral wire will flow here, then after that point a neutral is coming outside from this horizontal capping. So we will again indicate here one black line, smaller line indicating the path of a neutral wire. So this completes our wiring diagram for our one lamp control with the help of one switch. Now with this completion of this layout, we will be covering the layout with the help of a capping. So now our intention will be to cut the covering of a capping according to the length of the casing. So for that we will use hacksaw, as we have mentioned it in the tools. We will cut the length of a capping according to length of casing, and we will fix it in a proper way.
So here we can see it is matching the length, so we have to fix it. So now our wiring is covered. Same we have to do it for the vertical portion of the casing. We have to cut a capping of the same length by measuring the length, and then we will fix it. So this is our complete layout, students. Now our layout is completed. Here we can see. Now we have to connect a lamp in the lamp holder, and we have to make the connection of phase and neutral, and accordingly we have to note down the observations of this experiment. So here we can see that we are having one ceiling rose fixed here, and two wires are brought out from the ceiling rose, out of which one is phase wire and one is neutral wire. So as a safety precaution, we have used a PVC tape covering to ensure the safety, that in the on condition the supply is not available on the wire. So actually now we will be using a tester to check whether the availability of phase is there or not. So firstly we will fix a lamp here, and then we will make the connections of the phase and neutral. So we'll fix a lamp. So for our experiment we will be using a tungsten filament lamp. We can use it of any rating. So we will fix it in the lamp holder. We have to press it slightly and we have to turn it. Okay, so our lamp gets fixed here. So now these two wires, out of these two wires we have to check which is the phase wire and which is the neutral wire. So for safety reason we have to always make sure that we should not touch the conductor with the bare hand. For checking the availability of supply we will use a tester. So these two wires are been connected to 2-pin plug. Now they are not connected. I will connect it and show you how to detect the phase wire. So I have switched on. Now see, we will take a tester and I will touch it to the conductor. So you can see that the tester is glowing. So this is indicating a phase. You can see glowing of a tester. For the black wire, you can see if I touch the tester, it is not glowing. So it is indicating a neutral wire. So before making the connection, we again need to switch off the supply as a safety, and I will unplug it. Now we can first, we have to make sure that the supply is not coming before making the connection. So here we can see that the tester is not glowing. So this is the safety measure that we need to follow. So we will now twist this phase conductor and we have to connect it to the phase wire of our layout. So we have to twist it properly. We have to make the connection proper. So for that we can also use a plier to make the tightness of a proper connection. In this way we will twist conductors. We will bend them, and we have to use PVC insulation tape to properly insulate the joint. So this makes up a connection of our phase wire. Now we have to join neutral with the neutral wire. So this connection of neutral wire has been made. We will bend it and we will insulate it with the help of a PVC insulation tape. We have to make sure proper insulation is applied. So this completes our connections. So we have to make sure that before switching on the supply, our switch be in the off position. Now in this experiment, what we have to observe in the observation table, for different positions of the switch, as we are using a one-way switch, so only there are two positions. First will be off position, and for that we have to see the condition of the lamp, whether it is glowing or not. And obviously for off position, the lamp should not glow. And for on position of the switch, we have to observe the condition of lamp, whether it is glowing or not. So now I will connect the single phase AC supply. So I switched on the supply, but you can see that the lamp is not glowing. Why? Because the position of the switch is in the off condition. So this is the first observation, that the switch is in the off position and lamp is not glowing. We can see the lamp is dark. Okay. Now I will switch on the switch, change the position of switch, and we will observe that the lamp glows or not. So as I press, you can see the glowing of a lamp. So the switch is now in the on position. This is the on position of switch and the lamp is bright. So again I will switch it off. You can see the darkness of the lamp. So lamp becomes off. So for on position of switch, lamp glows. So these are the observations that we have to note down in this experiment. So this fuse will operate in the high current condition for safety, breaking the circuit for safety reasons. So at the end, we have to switch off the main supply and we have to unplug the connection for safety. So with this, let us understand the application where such kind of connection is used and move on to the conclusion. So students, we have seen in these experiments how to control one lamp with the help of one switch and fuse to be used in the circuit. So in the conclusion, we have to write that this type of wiring in which we will control the operation of one lamp with the help of one switch is used for domestic purposes, where we find in our house that we are controlling each and every individual appliance with the help of a single switch, and we use a fuse as a safety device for safety purposes in our wiring.